PeopleSoft now offers a remote worker feature for managers, administrators, and employees, which includes employee self-service, configurable approvals, adding attachments, and Kibana visualizations. Let's see how an employee can submit a remote worker request. Log in to the employee self-service homepage and click the remote worker tile. Here, you can see a list of remote work requests or create a new request. Click the Add Request button. Enter the start and end dates of the remote work request. If you don't know the end date, leave that blank. Identify whether this request is for working fully remote or if it will be a hybrid situation of working part-time from the office and part-time remotely. The remote worker pages use an activity guide to provide you with the flexibility to configure the steps needed for your organization. For example, the guideline steps can provide you with details about your company's policies for working remotely. Add an image, include instructional text, add a link to a policy, or even create a video to watch. You can create an agreement tailored to your organization using the acknowledgement framework. If you don't need an agreement, you can easily delete this from the activity guide. The Request Details page shows details about the remote work request. Here, you can enter information such as the reason for working away from the office and the remote work location. Using the Page and Field Configurator, every organization can determine which fields are required or remain optional. If you select Home, the system shows your home address from your personal information. Select Other to add a location that is not your home or workplace. The Workplace option allows you to choose from available company offices, since some employees choose to work from an office location closer to home rather than commuting into the corporate office. The percentage value helps to identify the amount of time you will be working remotely. Organizations can use this to assist in determining taxing implications for exempt employees that work remotely in different states and localities. It's important for the manager, administrator, or payroll manager to verify the accuracy of the percentage value. The hybrid option enables you to determine details about the days you work remotely. You can select average days per month, per week, or specify a daily schedule. You can select the days that you're planning to work remotely. It's important to note that the remote worker is not a scheduling or resource planning system. It provides your organization with an estimate of which employees will work remotely and when they will be working remotely. Employees that work fully remote do not have the option to complete the percentage or remote days, as they're working every day and 100% remote. You can add supporting documents or notes to the request. The attachment framework drives this page. Using the questionnaire framework, the organization can request additional information. For example, you can enter equipment details, internet access, and verify other requirements for a successful workplace environment. In the final step, the system summarizes all the information collected. You should review the details before submitting the request. Your organization can set the approval process up for managers, administrators, or even a payroll manager. The approver uses the approval pages to approve, deny, or push back the request. Now, let's see how a manager gets into the remote worker request details submitted by the employee. If approvals are turned on, you'll get a notification that the request is waiting. The approver can link to the notification in the right pane or use the Approvals tile. Click on Remote Worker and select the request to approve. Here, you can see important information about the request, as well as job details for the employee. You can approve, deny, or push back the request to the employee. The Remote Worker feature uses the approval framework, which enables you to make configuration changes to meet your organization's approval requirements. Managers and administrators can complete a remote worker request on behalf of an employee. The administrator can edit or delete a request as needed. Select the employee from the list, click on the Add Request button, enter the start date, and click Next. The employee acknowledgement and workplace support are not included for the manager or administrator, as this is normally completed by the employee. But since this is an activity guide, your organization can determine the steps that are relevant. The Remote Worker Configuration page enables you to provide the approval and request reasons by regulatory region. The Remote Worker Insight visualizations are created for the administrator to analyze the details of the organization's remote workforce. The ability to visualize information in charts and graphs is much more powerful than viewing raw numbers. These metrics show you the total number of employees and the subsets of fully remote, hybrid, and on-site employees. But with the pie chart, you can instantly see that almost half of your employee population is fully remote and less than a quarter of your employees work on-site. You can also quickly analyze the location of your workers. Here, you can see many of your employees work in a different office building. The Remote Workers by Department analytics shows how each department is handling remote working. How many employees are fully remote, on-site only, or working as a hybrid remote? This helps you to understand coverage and even a glimpse at office space allocation. This donut chart helps your administrator analyze the percentage of time that employees anticipate working remotely, while the bar chart indicates the most popular days for hybrid staff to be off-site. As with other Kibana analytics, you can select a filter at the top or an item in the visualizations and dynamically change the view of all reports. This helps you to view the data in multiple ways. At the bottom of the dashboard, a grid shows a list of employees that meet the selected criteria. The links take you directly to the employee job data or the remote worker details. In today's labor market, providing workers with the option to work remotely is a critical retention strategy. Tracking the activity is also critical to the management of work, assignments, and even understanding office resources. For more information, go to peoplesoftinfo.com.